This program is proudly brought to you by the Peel Dance Bar, corner of Peel and Wellington Streets, Collingwood.
This episode of Hellbent is proudly supported by Event Logistics. Let them look after your next folk festival, perhaps an arena spectacular, with style and a smile. And Home Comforts Australia, Pran Central's funkiest homeware store. They'll make your dreary house a groovy home.
Oh, it gets better every week, doesn't it? Welcome to another Hellbent. My name is Luke Gallagher, and with me on the sumptuous red mink couch is the gorgeous, the sumptuous Kay Sara, and the equally gorgeous and sumptuous Bunny McCoy. Make them welcome! Hooray!
Oh. Too sumptuous.
No. I know. This red mink.
I'm just about in case.
As you two have fallen into it, you're
Steve, singing. We're doing our best impression of two gorgeous pillows just for you, Luke.
Like
how are you?
You're doing so well. Have you had a good week, ladies?
Fabulous.
Yeah, busy.
Fabulous. Oh, very, very busy this time of year for me because why? It's autumn. You've got all those leaves everywhere, and that's a worry.
And you've got to rake, don't you?
You do have to
rake. You've got to rake those leaves
but
in.
But you don't have to shave your legs anymore.
No.
Which, as a beauty professional, saddens me deeply because I lose business, but on a, you know, time thing, because you're all covered up for winter.
Well, indeed. Mm. We've got another huge show for you this evening, ladies and gentlemen. Starting off, of course, with our musical guest, as we always do. Now, we've got a wonderful musical guest tonight, and his name is Trevor Mann. And Trevor has got a fabulous number for us this evening.
Bunny,
what's wrong?
It's a bit of a...
Trevor looks a bit upset.
Upset today.
Oh, what's happened?
Well, I think we should ask him because he's really not in the best of...
Okay, well, maybe we'll hand it over to Trevor Mann and see what he's got to say. Please make him welcome Trevor Mann.
I'd like to dedicate this song to my now ex-girlfriend, Brianna.
Is it so hard to satisfy your senses? You found out to love me. You have to climb some fences, scratching and crawling along the floor to touch you. And just when it feels right, you say you found someone to hold you.
Does she like I do? Bet she doesn't. No way. No way.
Baby, tell me, does she love you like the way I love you? Does she stimulate you, attract and captivate you? Tell me, does she miss you, existing just to kiss you like the way I do? Tell me, does she want you, infatuate and haunt you? Does she know just how to shock you, electrify and rock you? Does she inject you, seduce you and affect you like the way I do? Like the way I do. Can I survive all the implications, even if I try? Can you be less than an addiction? Don't you think I know? There's so many others that would beg, steal and lie if I can't die. Hold you. Baby, tell me, does she love you like the way I am, Brianna?
goodness me. Trev, have a tissue, pet.
Would you play tissues? Oh, God.
It's a bit of a sad old bar we've got here.
Oh, Jenny.
So I think what we're going to do, a bit later on, we're going to help people take their woes away with a bit of a cowboy cocksucker and Steve.
No problem.
But for the moment, I think back to the couch with Luke.
Yep.
Absolutely. Thank you, Lisa and Steve. Round of applause. And that was a special round of applause for Trevor Mann. Trevor, we're sorry to hear about your girlfriend. What was her name again, Bunny?
I think it was Brianna.
Brianna, I'm sorry to hear about that.
Luke, I'm here to tell you that toilet roll was just flowing so much there. It was just
It is a bit sad, but we are joined now by Mr. Michael Anderson, who is a board member of the Also Foundation Board and who's also co-convener of the Community Development Committee. Please make him welcome. I've got one of your plastic numbers. You can have that plastic number,
the
Michael.
The magic number today is number 5.
This is proudly brought to you by the number 5. Now, Michael, I'm sorry, that was all a bit of a jarble, but you are the convener of the Community Development Committee for the Also Foundation,
yep.
And you're also a board member of
yep.
Also. We've brought you on today to talk to us about the new position that's been created, also the Community Development Manager, and also what's happening in community development across the board with the Also Foundation.
Yeah, well...
It's a very broad question, so tell us everything.
Okay.
25 words or less.
In 25 words in 30 seconds.
That's right.
We do have a brand new person on board. Bernadette Brown is her name, and she's been on for about 3 months now, and she is fantastic.
Right.
She's helped us develop this magnificent plan, and now has actually gone and started the working on that plan and getting out there, meeting the community, and doing some of these projects.
Mm.
And she really is worth her weight in gold.
That's fantastic. We wanted to get her on tonight, and she couldn't make it this evening, so we're sorry to
hear. I think she's having her hair done.
She's getting her hair done. Good
she's
on you,
very
Bernadette.
Busy developing.
She's busy developing the community.
Yeah.
Now, because the Also Foundation obviously runs lots of dance parties, and they are run as fundraisers for the community, for the GLBT community, and we often talk about them as community fundraisers, but we don't often hear exactly what the funds are going into developing. So are there some examples that you can give us of where the money goes, if you like?
Well, certainly. The money that we make at dance parties, some of the profits go into the community grants program, and twice a year we have a major grand round and we give money directly back to the gay and lesbian community, some great projects.
Mm-hmm.
And
Are they normally organisations or individuals, or who applies for this money?
Mainly organisations and groups, but we do have individuals that are looking to, a group of individuals perhaps looking to set up a new group. So it's a wide range of projects, really, and some of the projects we fund are amazing and have a great potential to contribute to the community.
Fantastic.
In Victoria.
Because, I mean, Luke, the thing is, even like the smallest kind of publicity bills can be a drain on a small fledging group.
Yeah.
So you might provide funding just to sort of do a bit of a publicity round. For publication, for example. Because now Switchboard have been a recipient, haven't they?
Yeah, Switchboard, Bent TV.
Yeah, Bent TV has received.
We got some of your money and it was very nice too. Any chance of some more?
Join
You know. I was prostituting myself on air again, wasn't I? I must
what
stop doing
way.
That.
I'll talk to you after the show, Kat.
We'll have to get a letter. See if anyone's written in for Bent.
French letter. Again.
Well, that's always nice. What's a French letter?
I don't know, but it's one of those provocative statements.
Well, you have to explain it later. So, Michael, obviously Bernadette's position and what she's doing is pretty broad. I mean, it's a huge job. How does one person tackle something as large as Victoria's, put your number down, okay, as Victoria's well, gay, lesbian, bisexual and transgender
community?
Did Bernadette
get $5 for her funding? No.
$5,000? No, getting a little bit
$25,000.
A little bit more than $5,
yes,
and I won't say how much. But because of the parties, because of really, you know, paved and injured parties by the gay and lesbian community, we're in a position to hire somebody to do this work. But she also needs some help, and we really, at the foundation, we need some volunteers at the moment.
Right.
And so if anybody out there is interested in doing some really meaty and juicy community development projects and helping us out, we'd really appreciate it. And the best bet is to phone Bernadette. She's full-time at the Orso Foundation.
What's the number there?
It's at 9510-5569.
We should get some of your plastic numbers and line them up along the front.
Yes, we should.
9510-5569 is the number. Call me now. No, call the Orso Foundation. I'm getting all tongue-tied. Bernadette was telling me, actually, that some of the things that are happening is there are people going out into schools, there are members of the community going out to do public speaking about sexuality awareness. There's older people's projects developing.
Yes, I was wondering. So that's
I mean, there's
great.
A range of broad cross-section things. Sexuality awareness packs. I just wanted to
thank the gay and lesbian community for coming along to Resurrection a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah.
It was a huge success.
Fantastic.
And the funds we make go straight back into the gay and lesbian
community.
Which is
wonderful. Thank you, Michael Anderson from the Orso Foundation. And would you stick around and join our panel at the end of the show?
My pleasure.
Love your work. Thank you all. We're going to go to a break, but please thank Michael Anderson. We'll see you right after this. We are back. Oh, what an eventful and marvellous evening we're having here at Hellbent this evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's all happening. Now, we have now got some wonderful guests with you. They're from a performing arts background, K-Sara, and their names are Libby Caldwell and Mr. Brett Turner. Please make them welcome. Now, it's an interesting performing art that we're speaking about this evening because you've both just finished a smash hit season of your play, Libby, called The Lure, which was actually a radio play.
Yeah.
And how did that work in a comedy festival gig?
It worked really well.
Yeah.
Because I think in light of the fact that there is so much stand-up and so much of the same sorts of genres you'll find in the program this year, we offered a bit of a refreshing break to that.
Yeah.
And we're trying to sort of ride the wave of reinvention, so to speak.
Well, you had huge audiences. You did really well.
I mean, considering the venue was quite tiny.
You played at Blue Velvet?
Blue Velvet Bar and Nightclub. And we sort of packed that venue out, and it was quite nice for me to work in a small venue, have it sort of packed to the rafters, and then I'll go to bigger venues for me.
Absolutely. It's always best to start small, isn't it, Kay?
I think that's probably true. And I have to sort of do a bit of a John Laws thing here and disclose my interest.
Right.
I actually had the great privilege of working in this play.
No, I heard this, Kay.
And that's not so much of a gratuitous self-promotion, but just to say that it was a really interesting project to work in Luke. Radio, because I think the radio drama as a kind of a genre is not forgotten, Libby, but just like
neglected.
Really in need of reinventing.
Yes, I think so.
Where did you get the idea from?
I went to a seminar at the Film and Television Association thing. It was in South Melbourne. It's like a seminar thing. And we were listening to all these people who were in the industry talking about how they got their shows onto television. And I saw this really interesting thing by Brian Dore, if we all recognise him from his little bits with, is it John Clark and Brian Dore? Yeah. And he said that what people don't understand is that a lot of TV guys make their start in radio, and writing for radio makes you write. You can't think of anything else other than the words.
Well, there's none of that sort of waffly visual stuff that, that gets
no.
in the way, much like our program here, okay? It's all waffly visual stuff. Because, I mean, you're cutting straight to the chase, aren't you? I mean, people are only hearing it, they're focusing purely on what they're receiving orally, distinct from orally, don't get that wrong.
We kind of try and incorporate some sort of live element to it as well. So I think if we were to just stand there with a script and sort of read it, it would be kind of monotonous after a while, regardless of how interesting the story.
I didn't see the production, which I'm sorry to report, but did you have sound effects, Brett?
Most of the sound effects we actually did live.
Right.
Throwing
so like the
boxes
clop
around.
With coconut
there was a lovely pair of ruby red stilettos that went up the wall to for concrete and shoes on concrete and all that sort of stuff.
Cute.
Bank card machines for machine guns.
A very wow. special bicycle pump that made a sound like a dolphin.
Oh, yes. Can't yes, forget certainly. Flipper.
Who, did you do all this research on sound effects?
No, I just kind of went around my house and thought, sound effect, can I get out of this one? And sort of did. Oh, a dolphin, that'll go right then. More or less.
So it's like you get the sound effects first, then you write the show.
No, absolutely not.
We're excited because, we're thrilled to have you here with us, but you're actually going to do an excerpt from The Lure for us this evening on Hellbent. And it's in other programs and other commercial networks, they'd sort of drift away now. We'd leave it to you. But we're not going to do that. Kay and I are just going to sit right on down and have a listen. Now, what can you set up the scene for us? What is happening at this point?
Okay, well, the story is based around Galaxy Blue, which is a talent agency that's going under.
A talent agency?
Yes. Going under?
It's going under.
It is.
On the brink of extinction yet again. Okay. Remember that? Yes, and so the owner or founder has to do some drastic things and employs her daughter to come in and rule her stead while he goes off and gallivants across the country looking for people to sleep with, basically.
Looking for talent.
Yes.
Who's in this scene?
As they do.
In this scene is Vivian DeMilo, who is a megastar of huge proportion. And Gunther Moon, who is like, if you can conglomerate every TV legendary character, put it into one ball, it's kind of Gunther Moon all over.
Like in what style? Like mafioso?
Don Lane.
Oh. Don Lane. And that
Zig
kind
and Zag, the whole works.
Look, roll them all into one, Kate. Okay? Just so
it's
actually
more or less every Moomba Monarch you've ever had. It's rolled into
a Moomba Monarch. I must include it.
Okay, well, look, let's take it away. Set the scene and we'll just sit here quietly.
So I explain the scene first?
Please explain the scene.
Okay, the scene is we're on a boat and I have been persuaded through deceit and blackmail to go aboard a ship which is owned by Gunther Moon, and we're just going to be taking pictures for the sake of the paparazzi and then hopefully turn him into a stardom. But something else happens along the way.
Okay.
Get into character now. Okay.
Hi there, fair maiden.
Before you say another word, I am not wearing a life jacket. I'm packing a couple of floaties right here. Got any bourbon, I haven't had breakfast.
It's true what they say. You are a Venus.
You have an etiquette to be casting off now, Mr. Moon.
Aye, matey. A full steam ahead, Sanchez, my friend, but easy on the gas. We wouldn't want to rush things, would we?
Oh, bourbon!
May I call you Vivian?
Bourbon!
Champagne bourbon? The city looks beautiful from the ocean, don't you think? Come, take a look. You can see Gibraltar from here. The grand opening is next month, you know. I was only a boy when they tore down the hospital to make way for her enormous foundations. I never imagined that would ever be finished. Such architectural mastery.
Architecture? What architecture? It looks like a mountain. I mean, how hard could it be? I mean, it's not a building, it's a heap.
Nonsense, it's extremely avant-garde. Have you ever seen a structure like that in the world? A building made entirely out of glass. So big you can see it from orbit. Simply astonishing.
Oh, whatever. Look, you've got some pretty scary people working for you, pal, but I'm guessing you already know that, don't you, Chief? So, what's the use? What do you want with a woman of my caliber? Whatever it is, you must want it pretty bad to rattle my world, I can tell you. So, what kind of a name is Gunther anyway? I mean, it screams retarded, don't you know that?
Life is a personal journey, my love. We must travel its highways and byways alone and hold only ourselves responsible for our actions.
If you're planning on singing now, my ears have already bled today.
It just so happened that I spent a good deal of my journey in a bottle, so now I'm faced with total ruin if I don't restore myself to my former grandeur.
And you think pictures with me are gonna fool anybody? Good grief, talk about delusional.
My dear, you should know that in this business, it's all about leverage. Forgiveness lies in the lens of a camera. Now, pout in the direction of that buoy. Oh, look, a dolphin!
You know, I think I see a suspicious mole underneath your nipple. Or is that your navel? Let's be sure, put a goddamn shirt on!
Now, just relax.
What are you doing?
Say cheese.
What are you doing? Stay back! Look, I deliberately left my contacts at home. You come any closer and you'll be in focus. Stay back!
I find you excruciatingly attractive.
You're supposed to, but from way over there!
The sun is out. Why don't you shed some clothes and sun yourself on the upper deck? I've got some lotion and a loofah glove.
Help! Help! Roger! Where are you?
No one can hear you, my dear. Come, let us now shed our clothes and writhe beneath a burning sun.
Holy shit!
Mr. Moon.
Behold, let the world see my nakedness and judge me not for this, for this is my weapon, and as God can affirm, I am ready to conquer.
Mr. Moon.
Not now, Sanchez, later. Surrender now, and let the man in the moon show you a slice of heaven you'll be able to taste forever.
How dare you! Get off me, old man!
I am wanting your boot now, Mr. Moon.
Get the hell out of here, boy, I told you. Why are you putting that flare gun at me and dousing yourself in fuel?
Oh, thank God! Sanchez, honey! Shoot him! Shoot him! Shoot him! Not the radio, you putz! Moon, blow his head off!
Please be getting into boat now, Mr. Moon.
What are you talking about, boy? Can't a man take full advantage of a woman's cleavage without speculation?
My name is Sanchez Hormazibol, Mr. Moon. You will do as I say.
What do you want? I did nothing wrong. Sex is a beautiful thing.
I'm a fucking god in this town, Mr. In your history. At least somebody around here knows that a treat lady.
What are you talking about, Sanchez? What's going on?
Please be getting into lifeboat now, Mr. Moon.
But I...
Mr. Moon, if you do not get off boat, I will make very breezy your head. Yeah! Pinned up!
But my clothes!
Mr. Moon... Row away. Kaboosh!
Thank you. This was Libby Caldwell and Brett Turner from The Lure. I would say be on the lookout for a return season soon. That was fantastic. We'll stick around to the end of the show.
Thank you.
Love to have more. It was wonderful. Congratulations. Over to Bunny and Brett at the travel counter. Please make them welcome.
I think that was definitely the Stanislavski method acting of breast. That was fantastic.
I like the breast movement.
What Libby's tough act to follow. There.
Indeed. Now, our regular travel trouble spot, Brett, welcome back to your second week on Hellbent. What have we got this evening?
Well, it's been a big week in travel. Mm. Probably tonight we're going to talk about Algeria, North Africa. Algeria is probably one of the most dangerous spots to travel to at the moment, but it seems to be very popular. It's a little bit French, a little bit Arabic.
Oh.
Kind of like Catherine Deneuve meets Omar Sharif.
Oh, we're all going to love a bit of that, aren't we?
Do you like the outfit?
I do like that. I didn't say it's very Omar.
Yes, actually paired...
No Sharif in there, though.
No, paired with a pair of pink pants, hot pants, I could probably be mistaken for Don Dunstan. Yeah. But Algeria basically sits at the top of North Africa.
Mm.
And it's bordered between Libya and Morocco.
Mm-hmm.
Now, they've had troubles from about 1998 of Islamic fundamentalists.
Oh.
Yeah, now, a lot of people do want
You've
to visit there.
You've been studying now, haven't you?
Yeah.
You're sounding almost intelligent this
way. I know. Try saying Israeli fundamentalists three times really fast.
We won't try.
No, no.
Keep going.
So basically what it is, a lot of people are wanting to travel there, but there's a couple of things that we really need to know about.
Mm.
Firstly, the Department of Foreign Affairs is warning us that it's a no-go area.
Oh.
Okay. Now, they do have laws forbidding acts of sexual nature between people of the same gender.
Oh.
So that's something to be beware of. And Absolutely. The fine is either 2 years in jail.
Or 63 camels.
That's right. Or up to 8,000 dinners. That's diners, not dinners.
Oh.
Okay. So basically...
Dinners know that.
Dinners know what to do.
That's right.
Keep going.
That's the currency. In terms of a travel trouble spot, it's one to look out for, and I'm going to give it an 8.
Oh!
Goodness.
A super trouble spot in Algeria.
Well,
how do you handle trouble spots like Algeria with your beauty products?
Well, I was going to say, if that's a travel trouble spot, it's a beauty fucking nightmare, darling. Now, what you got to do is you're going to take what you've got on hand, okay? So they're going to have some sort of flatbread. You don't have to be a genius to work that out.
Okay.
Right. Okay.
Well, there you go.
What I'm going to do, we've got a bit of a dip made of your fabulous local nut-like product.
Ah, there you go.
Now, I don't know whether they do have the low-fat variety, but I quickly.
Okay.
We spread this on. What else have I got? I've got these fabulous falafel snacks that I'm sure you can get in Algeria.
Oh, fantastic.
Okay, we rub that on. Then what we do? Exfoliate, cleanse, and one wash.
Very nice.
Isn't that fantastic?
Love it. Mr. Brett Chan, Miss Bunny McCoy, once again giving you fashion tips for the new millennium. We'll be back right after this break. Woo!
Thank you.
Oh, okay. Oh.
not very karmic, was it? How are you?
I'm fantastic, Kay. Well, how are you?
I can't help but think, Luke, that your aura is a little bit muddy. Am I right?
And that and the fact that I've noticed you've changed your hair colour in the course of 45. What's going
it's
on?
It's very topical. Today in Kay's Corner, we are doing a little bit of an experiment with your auras. I want to cleanse your aura, Luke.
Well, because I'm very black.
Yes, very black. And I know that you're going to New York.
I am indeed.
And
Kay,
I think you could do with a little bit of a karmic lift.
It's a very dirty city. Yes.
It is a dirty city. Yes. It's a fabulous the way we're coming through the speaker. We all sound like God, don't we?
More. All this noise.
Well, you mentioned the hair. The hair is inspired, of course, by Miss Shirley MacLaine.
Give her a round of applause.
There she is, going within. And you know what, Luke? You could use Shirley MacLaine's books for inspiration.
To take with me.
You could, or you could just chuck them away. I don't think it matters too much.
Either or.
Or you could have a read of this book. This is Georgina Bayer.
Yes, she's...
And the title of her book, Luke, is called Change for the Better.
Now, she's... am I right in saying she was a Jewish trans...
Maori.
Maori,
transgendered.
Sorry. Transgendered.
Lady, the first transgendered person to, in fact, be a mayor.
That's right. I knew there was a connection there somewhere.
Let's get down to research.
There's now, what are you doing? There's all of this karmic produce.
It doesn't look like it's ever going to come together. That, in fact, is a little toilet.
What do I do? Do I put these on my
put
nipples?
Put that on your nipples.
Okay,
why not?
Good. Because look, it's working.
Yes, a bit of nipple stimulation won't go
straight. Right, good.
Did you put your finger on that, Luke?
I did.
And what happened?
Oh, a naughty thing came out. Okay, look at that. One more time. Oh, yes. That's cute. Now, what are you doing to me? You've got something about
all. Because that's where your life is at the moment. It's going down the
toilet.
Symbolism. You need to put this around your neck. This is an EIP.
What does
and
that
it's
mean?
A special shield, and that means everybody in peace. Actually, it doesn't, but
I'm feeling that's a stretch, but we'll go with it.
Fabby. Now, also here we have a little bit of water. And do you notice
cleansing.
That water?
Oh,
20 cent piece.
So it's a wishing well.
Money is very dirty. That's it. Bless yourself.
I'm loving
it. A bit of rock salt. I think it's a good idea.
I'm not going to waste it, am I?
No, you don't have to do anything but just look at that and think pure thoughts.
I'm thinking very pure thoughts at this
now,
point.
Now, ideally what you do is you'd let that money sit in there for about... 20 years, so that it's nice and clean.
And it'll rust.
And then you take it out if you're still alive. Put that in your little hand. And at this stage, of course, I am going to... Are you feeling...
I'm feeling blessed.
Yes, it's already going straight to your oral centre.
I'm loving it. Now, where does this go from here?
You need to hold the number one.
Number one, okay.
The number one
below the nipples, yes.
Symbolic, Luke, of fact, you are the number one person in your universe. And at this point, I do ask Latisse to come over and give us a hand.
Oh, Latisse!
Come over
here,
Latisse.
Hello, Latisse.
How are you, darling?
Oh, I'm fabulous. How are you
doing?
So what
now, Luke, can you sit yourself down in the centre of that little box there?
I'm probably going to break it. Oh, I think it's
you'll be okay. Can you cross your legs, dear?
You're asking a lot, aren't you, Kay?
Do the best you
can. Hold on. Oh, it's calisthenics.
I'll just get this out of the way.
Martha Graham, eat your heart out.
Now, we're just creating a little pyramid above you here because we need to channel your energies. There goes the toilet, you see? It's absolutely true, isn't it?
It's beautiful. Do you hold that, Latisse?
Yes, I've got.
Before we do anything, get one of those balloons, if you would, Latisse, and put that over the candle. Make it go bang. That, in fact, is to scare away all the evil spirits. Are you feeling karmic?
I'm feeling so...
And you see how
so
Latisse
relieved.
Has created a little pyramid there, which is centering your energy.
Okay,
and you're
I'm
feeling
channeling.
Fabulous
I feel
there.
Like I'm channeling New York cabaret.
Hold your number one. Don't forget you're the centre of your universe.
I'm loving it. I'm feeling pig-like. I'm feeling like we need some more entertainment.
Pegs on the feet.
Hold your toilet.
Do you think... Okay, this works for me.
Just to keep him anchored.
Anchor him to the ground. Peg him down.
Peg him down.
That's right.
This is lovely, ladies. But we've got somebody that's far more important than I'll ever be.
And
his name is Shane Hewitt. And he's here to sing for us tonight on Hellbent. And he's singing a wonderful jazz... they caught me. Jazz standard, and it's called Skylark. Would you make him welcome Shane Hewitt, ladies and gentlemen?
There a meadow in the mist where someone's waiting to be kissed? Oh, skylark, have you seen a valley green with spring where my heart can go a-journeying? over the shadows and the rain to a blossom-covered lane, and in your lonely flight, haven't you heard music in the night? Wonderful music, faint as a will-o'-the-wisp, crazy as a loon, sad as a gypsy serenading the moon. Skylark, I don't know if you can find these things, but my heart is riding on your wings. So if you see them anywhere, won't you lead me there?
Oh, Sam Hewitt. That was fabulous. Thank you so much. Hey, you're probably going to have to speak, you might have to grab that mic again. Sorry, before we go, I just wanted to chat about you and what you've done. You've done shows at Capers in the past.
Yes, I did a show there in March and one in December.
And you've come from a background in performing arts management and administration.
Yeah, well, I started in the business as a long-haired, drug-crazed rock singer. back in the late 60s, early 70s, too long ago to remember. But and then I got involved in management, and then I decided before it was retirement time, I should sing again. So I'm having fun.
Well, luckily you did. And also you run an online and internet shop selling CDs of cabaret artists and all sorts of people from around Australia.
I do, yeah.
It's called Middle Eight Music.
Middle Eight Music. It started as a hobby with my own stuff, and then friends started asking me to add their CDs, and it just grew and grew.
And
I specialise in Australian cabaret, theatre, jazz.
And I know you have a lot of stuff that a lot of other people wouldn't probably hold or distribute.
Yeah, a lot of independent product.
If we want to get to the site, it's www.middle8music.com.
No, just middle8.com.
Middle8.com.
Yep.
So go and check it out. Yep. Mr. Shane Hewitt.
Lots of fabulous Australian artists.
Absolutely. Well, and thank you for supporting those artists, because we all need all the support we can get.
Absolutely.
Thank you again. Come on over and join us at the couch.
Do you want me to bring this mic?
Bring the mic. Come on over. Oh. Now, I think I've done the wrong thing. I do believe it's my fault. We're meant to go over and see Bunny and Lettice at the bar. Sorry.
I think Luke might actually be getting his pyramid. He's a little off colour, don't you
think? I think so, yes. He's a bit ditzy.
Well, look, I wasn't getting any satisfaction from the previous staff, I'll have you know. So what I've done, I've brought in the aptly named Lettice Deluxe to actually mix me the sort of drink I want, because you are a woman after my own heart, and I've heard you know how to cocksuck a cowboy pretty big time.
Well, I think the drink is actually called a cock-sucking cowboy, or better known, a cowboy that sucks cocks. But still, what we're supposed to be doing is making it in a shot glass. But we're going to throw that
one
out.
Well, can we show first of all the standard one, just so people know what it looks like.
Standard. Oh, okay. Okay,
so we're making it very easy.
So you just pour in. Now, this is butterscotch schnapps.
Schnapps, yes.
Schnapps, I love that. And then we top it with a bit of Baileys.
Right.
And
okay.
Now, what you're supposed to do,
and I'll demonstrate that,
throw that back.
Right, like this.
That's why they call it. That's why they call it a shot.
Now that didn't even touch
the
side.
So I'm going
to
make one in a martini glass, because I think that a real woman like myself would never throw anything back like that. So that's a bit of butterscotch there.
Oh, that's
more
like
it. Pump it up with Baileys.
Oh, keep going, doll. Keep going.
Well, yes,
that's
we're not measuring
basic,
anything.
I think, isn't it?
Now, as a real woman, I would use a straw and just suck it back like this.
Goodness me, she's fabulous, isn't she?
Oh, that's why they call me Lettice the Lush.
Okay, well, look, let's recap.
That's
to make a real woman's cock-sucking cowboy.
Or a cowboy that sucks cocks.
Butterscotch schnapps in the biggest glass you can find.
What about this one?
Topped with Baileys.
How do you think that would go?
I think we'll worry about that and we'll pop back over to the couch.
Woohoo!
Because I'm feeling a little bit bent and bothered.
Thank you, Bunny. Thanks, Bunny McCall. Well, as Bunny said, she's feeling a little bent and bothered, and so are all of us here at Bent TV tonight on Hellbent. So we've got another letter. We've had another one, another person writing in. Isn't it extraordinary? They keep coming, Bunny, and I can't put a stop to it. Dear Bent and Bothered, on a recent two-week vacation to Jupiter's Casino on the Gold Coast, I met and fell in love with the Blackjack croupier. Is that how you pronounce it, croupier?
I don't know, but I thought you made a Freudian slip there,
though. What, black? Blackjack, keep going. My problem is, sorry, Bunny, I can't stop thinking about him, but I lost so much money at the casino, I can't afford to go back there to tell him how I feel. Oh, poor love. What should I do? Signed, broke and heartbroken in Broadmeadows. Oh, dear. We've got a bit of a problem here, ladies and gentlemen. Broken, heartbroken, he's lost all of his dough and he's fell in love with a croupier. What should he do? Brett Turner from The Lure, what do you think?
Sell your body to make the money for the next airfare.
Ah, well, simple, short and sweet. Love it. Round of applause. Michael from Also, what do you feel broken, heartbroken should be doing?
I'm thinking dance parties, I reckon.
Dance party. Okay, well, there's another option.
Ever get the feel that you live in one big commercial?
Yeah. Yes, my life is one big cash for comment.
That's right. Speaking about commercials, Winter Days is June.
In a couple of weeks, yeah. That's right. Moving right along. But wait. Brett, have you got a mic?
I have got a mic.
Oh, you have?
Yes.
You?
Yeah, he's at home though. I think, look, there's no good throwing good money after bad money. Get down to Crown. We've got some fantastic blackjack dealers down there. Baccarat, roulette. Support the local product.
Good on you. That's true. You might find a man of his dream. Thanks, right. Brett. Very solid and sound advice. Shane Hewitt, do you have anything to say to broken and heartbroken?
I couldn't have any more than go down to Crown and find a nice croupier.
Support our own multi.
Do they have black croupiers? I mean, blackjack.
I think we can find some.
Anything Queensland can do, we can do better.
That's exactly right. Yes. Libby, what do you think?
Ah, craps.
Ah. Aptly put. That's really enough. Thank you. Craps to that. And what about Lettice and the lovely Bunny McCoy?
I think we should get down to the Crown Casino and support the Crown myself. And I've been down there, and I'll tell you what, there's some pretty stunning guys down there.
If they rename it Tiara, I shall think about it.
Until you're going.
No way. I think that person's a card short of a deck, quite frankly. Crown Casino. I mean, they should just pop on down to Broadmoor. Meadows Tax Pokies.
Absolutely.
The golden nugget.
Because it's not called Tax Pokies for nothing.
Bunny, beautifully said. Kay, you've spoken, haven't you?
Don't yes, I've spoken. Yes. I'm naturally travelling if I were him.
Yeah, well, then you are. You're probably going to be doing
I
that
move
next
when
next
your mind
week.
Can go anywhere you want
well,
to.
At
the but how do you work so with your frequent flyer points? So I want to know.
That is all we have got time for tonight on Hellbent. Please join us again next week and thank all of our wonderful guests tonight. We hope you've enjoyed the show. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Supported by Event Logistics. Let them look after your next folk festival, perhaps an arena spectacular with style and a smile. And Home Comforts Australia. Cran Central's funkiest homeware store. They'll make your dreary house a groovy home.